Greetings and welcome to lecture series on thermodynamics. Today we will be looking at how to increase the efficiency of Rankine cycle. There are various methods by which we can do this. Before moving on to the next topic, we'll see what we have studied in last lecture. So we had seen the different components of power plant: boiler, turbine, condenser, and feed water pump. These are the four main components. We saw why we don't use Carnot cycle for power cycles. Then we had seen four processes of Rankine cycle. So process 1 to 2 will be isentropic expansion in turbine, and we had seen different inlet conditions for turbine. So if point number 1 dash is taken, means point number 1 steam is wet steam. If you consider point number 1, which is on saturated vapor curve, point 1 means steam will be dry and saturated steam. And if you consider point number 1 double dash, steam will be superheated steam at the entry of the turbine. And depending on the entry of the turbine, you can see exit of the turbine quality is increasing. So superheating is preferred here because you can see quality at the exit of the turbine is increasing. This we have seen. Process 2 to 3 is constant pressure heat rejection in condenser. Process 3 to 4 is isentropic compression pumping action. And 4 to 1 is constant pressure heat addition in the boiler. So we had seen PV diagram, TH diagram and HH diagram for this. Already everything is discussed. We had done the analysis of this. We had seen all the equations related to Rankine cycle, which are all the heat supplied, heat rejected, work developed by turbine, work consumed by the pump. Everything depends on change in enthalpy. So unit of this will be what? Kilojoule per kg. So it's unit you have to remember. And we had seen efficiency formula. Now here it is important to note that we had seen that for a cycle, since this is a cycle, see individually if you view the components of a Rankine cycle, turbine is a open system. Okay, if you consider a single device, but when all the components like turbine, condenser, pump, boiler, they are connected in series and it is forming a closed loop cycle. Okay, so here you have to understand that since this is a cycle, you can apply first law of thermodynamics. And what is the first law of thermodynamics? Summation of work during a cycle is equal to summation of heat during the cycle. So you can replace that summation of work by what? W net. So here I have written W net. And W net can also be written as what we had discussed is Q net. And Q net will be Q supplied in the boiler or QS or Q1, and heat rejected will be Q2 or QR. Now, one more thing I wanted to stress about this point is, if you consider W net, what is W net? We have studied this before. W net is area under PV diagram. What is work done? Work done is area under PV diagram. So if you consider PV diagram, and when I say W net is there, that W net will be the area enclosed in the cycle as shown over here. So here you can see red color area. This area will be W net. Similarly, when I say that W net is equal to Q net, which is equal to QS minus QR. So what I can write? Rankine cycle efficiency is Q net upon QS, QS minus QR upon QS, which is equal to 1 minus QR upon QS, which is equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1. Now this efficiency of Rankine cycle becomes equal to the efficiency of which we had seen in second law of thermodynamics, engine. So now if you see this Q net, what is Q? Q is area under TH diagram. So if you see the cycle 1, 2, 3, 4, we are considering 1 as superheated. Okay, I am considering 1 as superheated point. That is why I am drawing it like this. It depends what is the point number 1. So basically when I am explaining, considering point number 1 as entry, this one, superheated steam. So what will be Q net? It will be area inside this cycle. Okay, that is Qnet. Now, what is this Rankine cycle efficiency? It is Qnet upon Qs. Now, where is heat supplied? Heat is supplied in the boiler. What is the process? 4 to 1. So, I can write it in this way also. Rankine cycle efficiency is area enclosed over here, which is Qnet, divided by Qs. Now, what is Qs? Area under 4 to 1. Okay. So, same thing I have mentioned over here. The thermal efficiency can also be interpreted as the ratio of area enclosed by the cycle on TS diagram, which will be what? Qnet, which I just showed, to the area under heat addition process. Now, what is the Qnet? This is Qnet. And what is this Qs? It will be this area. So, this Qs area will be under 4 to point number 1 entry to the turbine. Okay, whichever point you are considering out of this three. It's like that. Now, we have seen definition of specific steam consumption and work ratio. Next definition is heat rate. So, what do you mean by heat rate? It is the conversion efficiency of power plant. And often, it is expressed in terms of heat rate. And it is the amount of heat supplied in kilojoule to generate 1 kilowatt hour of electricity. Now, what do you mean by 1 kilowatt hour? This is 1 unit of electricity. So, what is the amount of heat supplied in kilojoule to generate 1 unit of electricity, 1 kilowatt per hour, 1 kilowatt hour. So, heat rate will be, the what is the formula? 3600 upon efficiency of Rankine cycle. What is the unit of this? Kilojoule per kilowatt hour. What is the kilojoule of heat supplied to get 1 unit of electricity, 1 kilowatt hour of electricity. Now, compare this heat rate and steam rate. Okay, this is specific steam consumption or steam rate. In this steam rate formula, it is 3600 upon Wnet, whereas in heat rate, it is 3600 upon efficiency. So, heat rate and efficiency are related. So, smaller the heat rate, so if you take heat rate in the denominator and take efficiency in the numerator towards left hand side, what you will find is when heat rate is small, efficiency will be greater. Now, comparison also we had seen of Rankine cycle. Okay, these three diagrams we had seen in last lecture. Now, we'll see how the actual vapor power cycle is defined and how it is different from idealized one. So, whatever we had seen was ideal vapor power cycle. Now, we will see what is the actual vapor power cycle. What are the different losses which are there in actual vapor Rankine cycle, vapor power cycle. So, first loss is what? Fluid friction. So, fluid friction causes pressure drop. So, if you see over here, this is TS diagram. This process 1 to 2 will be expansion in turbine, 2 to 3 will be heat rejection in condenser, 3 to 4 is isentropic compression, and 4 to 1 is constant pressure heat addition in boiler. This is actual, which is shown by a solid line. Now, if you can see this dotted line or hidden line over here, this represents the actual cycle. Okay. Now, in case of actual cycle, there will be pressure drop in the boiler. So, here you can see from 0.4 to 0.1, there will be a pressure drop. You can see the hidden line, which is below the actual ideal reversible heat addition process, constant pressure heat addition process. So, below this you will have pressure drop. So, pressure is less. Similarly, there are different piping and components available where you will be having pressure drop. Now, in condenser also, if you see from this point, point number 2, this will be point number 2 to point number 3, you can see this pressure. This is inclined line, means pressure is reducing. Okay, so here also, you can see pressure is reduced as compared to actual pressure. And in this case, condenser also, you can see pressure is dropping. Now, in case of condenser, pressure drop is usually small. Now, in actual condenser, the liquid here you can see the outlet of the condenser. It is shown as saturated liquid, but in actual condensers, this point number, this one is 1, 2, and 3. Point number 3 usually lies in subcooled liquid region to prevent cavitation. Okay, we are not going in details of cavitation. You will find this information on the internet. You can have read about this. So that is why usually subcooling is done inside the condenser. Also, one more point I had told you that usually condenser pressure is less than atmospheric pressure. Now, where are the leakage losses? Okay, steam leaks out during the cycle. Okay, so steam will be high pressure in the boiler, so there could be leakages at some of the points. And if you consider condenser is a low pressure device. So in condenser, there will be heat leakage. So heat will leak inside the condenser. Why? Because see, air will flow from high pressure region to low pressure region. Okay, now condenser is low pressure as compared to atmosphere. So air will flow from atmosphere inside the condenser. Now because of this, there will be a negative effect. Okay, corrosion will increase when air is added into the condenser. So there is a solution for this. How this is prevented, we will see afterwards. Now finally, the power consumed by the auxiliary equipment such as fan that supply air to the furnace. So if you consider boiler, what happens in boiler, there will be water, and that water is heated and converted into steam. So how is that heat created? Using fossil fuel. So we require a furnace, and fan is used to supply air to the furnace. So some power will be consumed by fan also. So power consumed by fan and etc. other power consumed should also be considered when you calculate the overall performance of the power plant. Now we have not talked about this one. Okay, so if you see process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression. But what do you mean by this isentropic compression? It is reversible and adiabatic. Reversible means when the process occur, it doesn't have any effect on environment. Okay, both system and surrounding can return to its original state. So it is reversible and it is adiabatic. Adiabatic means turbine is assumed to be insulated. Similarly, if you see this pump, here also we consider that it is pumping action is also isentropic. So it is reversible and frictionless. So isentropic process. But in actual case, there will be some friction. So this process will not be isentropic, and because of friction, there will be increase in entropy. So you can see this line is a bit slanted one. And if you consider point 1, entropy is less. And if you consider point 2, the entropy value is more. You can see this point 2, it has shifted towards right. Let me show you that point. So if you consider this point, see this point is over here, and point number 2, it has shifted towards right. So the entropy value has increased. Similarly, in case of pump, this is the inlet of the pump, and because of friction, in actual case here you can see point, this is point 3, and point 4 has shifted towards right. So point 4 has shifted because there will be friction, and because of the irreversibility, entropy is increasing. So here you can see entropy has increased. So here also, in case of actual system, actual turbine, you can see that entropy is increasing and the point is shifting towards right. In case of pump also, you can see point is shifting towards right. It will not be isentropic in actual case. Now, since we don't have this ideal or isentropic process in the turbine, and we follow some actual process 1 to 2, we need to define a particular terminology which is known as isentropic efficiency of turbine. So here I have shown this process. Okay, so process 1 to 2 is what? Isentropic. This is enthalpy versus entropy diagram, Mollier diagram, HS diagram. So I have shown higher pressure, boiler pressure, and this one is lower pressure, condenser pressure, P2. So here you can see actual process, ideal process is process 1 to 2i, which will be isentropic expansion. So this is isentropic process. and work which is obtained is isentropic work WI or ideal work. Now, since turbine is power producing device, you should note that ideal work should be greater than actual work. Why? Because we require power. Power is generated. So ideally power generation should be more. That is why W ideal or W isentropic is greater than W actual. In pump it will be reversed. Why? Because pump is power consuming device. Turbine is power producing device. So in this case WI value is more. Now since there is irreversibility, point 2 has shifted towards right. Why? Because entropy is increasing. You can see on x-axis entropy is increased. So what is the actual work now? It will be H1 minus H2. What is ideal work or isentropic work? It will be H1 minus H2i. Now this can be part of a term which is known as isentropic efficiency of turbine. Now efficiency is always less than 1. So how you will define this efficiency? It will be ratio of WA upon WI, smaller value upon larger value. So efficiency of turbine is actual turbine work WA divided by isentropic turbine work which is WI. Now what is WA? Actual work is H1 minus H2. What is isentropic work? It is H1 minus H2i. Now we will move on to isentropic efficiency of pump. Now pumping action, if you see again this TH diagram, pumping action is over here, 3 to 4 process. So in case of pump, now pump is which type of device? Power consuming. So ideally pump should consume less power. So here you can see isentropic work is less as compared to actual work. Now 1 to 2 process you can see over here, this is 3 to 4 4i process, this will be isentropic pumping. Now this will be isentropic means it is reversible and adiabatic, but in actual case there will be some irreversibility because of friction, and you can see because of that irreversibility entropy is increasing. 0.4 has shifted towards right. Now what is isentropic work? It will be H4i minus H3. What is the value of actual work? It will be H4 minus H3. So we can define isentropic efficiency of pump. So what will be isentropic efficiency of pump? It will be isentropic pump work, which is this smaller value, upon larger value, which will be actual pump work, WA. So isentropic pump work is H4i minus H3 divided by actual pump work is H4 minus H3. Now just compare the values, compare the definition. Here you have in the numerator for pump isentropic and denominator it is actual. But for turbine, actual is in the numerator and isentropic is in the denominator. So how you can remember this? With the help of this diagram. Okay, how to remember this? Smaller value upon larger value. So smaller value will be WA for turbine and larger value will be WI. For pump it is reversed. What is the smaller value? It will be WI and larger value is WA. So from diagram you can write down the formula. Now next concept, mean temperature of heat addition. And using this concept we will study how we can increase the efficiency of Rankine cycle. So in Rankine cycle, if you see process 1 to 2, let me explain over here. Process 1 to 2 is isentropic. I am considering point 1 as inlet of the turbine, which is steam is superheated condition for this explanation. So 1 to 2 S is what? It will be isentropic expansion in turbine. 2S to 3 is constant pressure heat rejection in condenser. 3 to 4S, this will be isentropic compression in pump. And 4S to 1, this will be constant pressure heat addition in boiler. Now here it is important to note that heat addition in boiler it occurs at different temperatures. Okay, so during phase change, the temperature is remaining constant. Here you can see temperature axis, temperature has remained constant. Now when you consider this part, here the temperature is constantly increasing, and again if you consider this part, here again the temperature is increasing. So heat is added at this point also, continuously from 4H to 1. Now if you see this, let me show you this one. So heat is added at infinite temperature values. Okay, so from this point to this point, values of temperature is continuously increasing. Here it is remaining constant. Again, from this point, it is continuously increasing, point to point. Now, if you consider mean temperature of heat addition, which is this topic, since if you consider this phase change as base, so if you consider this superheating process, this is increasing the mean temperature of heat addition. Why? Because this is the actual temperature of heat addition and we are going above this. So mean temperature of heat addition is increased because of superheating. But if you consider this blue color part, 4S to this point, okay, suppose this is this point, suppose this point is 4, for example, and this point is 4 dash. So from 4 to 4 dash, this heat addition process, it is at lower temperature corresponding to saturation. So this heat addition process is at lower temperature. So this process is actually bringing down the mean temperature of heat addition. Okay, this I wanted to stress. Why? Because we will be trying to shift this point number 4 on the top afterwards. Okay, so basically what do you mean by this TM1, mean temperature of heat addition? From 4H to 1, the temperature is constantly changing. Here it is remaining same, again here it is increasing. So this is the average temperature from this point to this point. It is TM1. Now, this temperature I have considered TM1 and bottom temperature I am considering T2. Now, if TM1 is the mean temperature of heat addition as shown in figure, so that area under 4S to 1 is equal to area under 5-6. So what do you mean by this is, I am replacing this 4S to 1, this curve, let me highlight the curve. I am replacing this curve with this one, 5 to 6, such that area under 4H to 1, so this area, if you consider this area, blue color area, will be equal to area under 5 to 6. So this TM value is such that we can replace 4S by TM1, so that heat is added at, it is assumed that heat is, we can add at constant temperature. It's like that, but in actual case we are adding heat at constant pressure. Now, so what will be the formula of heat addition? It will be, this we have already seen, it will be H1 minus H4S. Now what is the entropy value for this? It will be, what is the mean temperature of heat addition? It will be TM1. So TM1 multiplied by, what is the entropy of this point number 6? It can be either S6, it can be 2S, or it can be S1. So why? Because it is, you can see this is vertical line. So I am taking this value. Now we are considering this process 5 to 6. Now when we write this Q1, I have written it in two ways. First part of the Q1, H1 minus H4S, I have written using this one, this point H1 and this point 4S. When I am writing this part of the equation, I am considering this line 5 to 6, horizontal line. Okay, this is horizontal line. So what is the mean temperature of heat addition? It will be TM1 multiplied by what is the entropy, it will be this entropy minus this entropy. Now this entropy is S1 minus this point entropy, it can be either 4S, it can be 5 or it can be 3. So I am taking 4S. So I can write TM1 in bracket S1 minus 4S. So what will be the mean temperature of heat addition from here? Mean temperature of heat addition will be H1 minus H4S divided by, this will go over here, it will become S1 minus S4S. Now what is heat rejected? Heat is rejected in condenser from process 2S to 3. So heat rejection will be H2S minus H3. And in terms of the area of rectangle, what you can write? T2S, what is the entropy of this point? S1 minus S4S. Okay, for this point also you can see, note this, this is horizontal line. Okay, let me show this horizontal. So for this point, again the entropy can be three values, either 2S, 6 or 1. And similarly, for this point also you have entropy 3, 4S or 5. So what I can write? T2 into, for this point I am writing S1 minus S4S. This point, point number 3 is equal to point number S4S when you consider entropy. So what is the efficiency of Rankine cycle? It is equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1, heat rejection upon heat addition, equal to 1 minus Q2 value is T2 S1 minus S4S divided by, what is Q1 value? It is TM1 in bracket S1 minus S4S. So this will get cancelled. What is the efficiency formula now? It will become Rankine cycle efficiency is 1 minus T2 upon TM1. Now using this formula, you can see definition of mean temperature of heat addition. What is this? Mean temperature of heat addition is enthalpy increase during heat addition process. So here you can see H1 minus H4S. This is enthalpy increase. Okay. So from 4S to 1, if you go, you can see enthalpy is increased divided by entropy increase during heat addition. So from 4S to 1, when you move from S4S to 1 point, you can see over here in entropy is increasing on x-axis. So enthalpy increase during heat addition divided by entropy increase during heat addition process is the formula of mean temperature of heat addition. So Rankine cycle efficiency is 1 minus T2 by TM1, where, now what is this T2? See this T2. T2 is heat rejection temperature. Now if you consider atmospheric pressure, atmospheric temperature, so this T2 temperature can be fixed by atmospheric temperature. Okay, why? Because heat can be rejected at atmosphere. So temperature, what is T2? Heat rejection temperature. And the lower temperature T2 for a it is for given TM1. Now the lower the value of T2, higher will be the value of efficiency of Rankine cycle. But this T2 value, lowest, it is fixed by what? Surrounding temperature. You can go below the surrounding temperature provided you are maintaining low pressure in condenser. If you are maintaining atmospheric pressure, then you can go up to only surrounding temperature in condenser. But if you maintain low pressure in condenser, then you can go below the surrounding temperature. So if you consider atmospheric pressure in the condenser, this temperature will automatically be fixed. So this is fixed, T2 is fixed. So now what we can say is Rankine efficiency is function of mean temperature only. So higher the mean temperature of heat addition, higher will be the cycle efficiency. Now this TM1 value, it is, you can see this TM1 value, this is higher temperature in the Rankine cycle. You cannot go beyond certain value. Why? Because we have metallurgical considerations also. So same thing has been written over here. The maximum temperature is fixed from metallurgical considerations. So basically, from this analysis of mean temperature of heat addition, what is the conclusion which we get? Rankine cycle efficiency is function of mean temperature of heat addition. So higher this value, mean temperature of heat addition, higher will be the cycle efficiency. So now we will see what are the different methods of increasing efficiency. And all the methods will focus on what? Increasing mean temperature of heat addition. So what are the methods of increasing the efficiency of Rankine cycle? First one is lowering condenser pressure. Second one is superheating steam to a high temperature. Third one is increasing the boiler pressure. Fourth one is reheating. Fifth one is regeneration. And next one is binary cycle. Many more things are there. Okay. We will be considering only up to regeneration. Now, numericals which you have, they are mostly on Rankine cycle and reheat. So first part, lowering the condenser pressure. So first understand the TS diagram. So if you see this TS diagram, what is shown? 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is the actual cycle. This is the Rankine cycle which is being followed. And since we have to reduce the condenser pressure, it is shown over here, lowering the condenser pressure. So here you can see, I am lowering the condenser pressure from 0.2 to 2 dash. So, and for comparison purpose, I am maintaining 0.1 as same. So what will be the first cycle? First cycle will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. And for second cycle, we are keeping 0.1 as same. And we are lowering the condenser pressure. So what is the second cycle now? 1, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 2, 1. This is second cycle. Now understand what happens over here. Now we have already discussed that Q net is equal to W net. So even if this is TS diagram, I can talk in terms of W net. So for comparison purpose, the inlet state of the turbine, it is maintained as same for both the cycles 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 1 or the second cycle 1, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 2, 1. In both the cases, 0.1 is maintained as same. Okay, only we are lowering the pressure, condenser pressure from P2 to P2 dash. So here you can see there is net increase in W net. Okay, even heat, there will, if you see original heat addition process, it is from 4 to 1. Now because of lowering of the condenser pressure, the heat addition requirement has increased. Initially it was 4 to 1. Now you can see it is from 4 dash to 1. So you can see this heat addition has also increased. But this heat addition effect, heat input effect, which is increasing, it is small as compared to the increasing W net. So what will be the overall effect? Overall effect will be increase in the thermal efficiency of cycle. Why? Because W net is increasing. Even the QS is increasing, heat supplied, but this value is small as compared to increase in W net. So to take the advantage of this increased efficiency at low pressure, the condenser of the steam power plant usually operates well below the atmospheric pressure. So usually it operates well below atmospheric pressure, and because of that, there are chances of air leakage in the condenser. The lower limit of the condenser pressure that can be used, it is also there is a limit. And because of this lowering the pressure in the condenser, there are possibility of air leakage. We already discussed this part. So here you can see, when you, if you see the actual cycle, see cycle 1, 2, 3, 4 to 1, point number 2 quality is more. And when we are actually lowering the condenser pressure, point 2 has been shifted to a lower quality. Means it will have negative effect on the turbine blades. Turbine blades will erode. So quality, by lowering the condenser pressure, quality of the steam also reduces. Okay, this point also you have to remember. Now next one, superheating steam to high temperature. Now why is this superheating done? If you consider 0.1 over here, If superheating is done, we get 0.1 dash over here. So mean temperature of heat addition has increased, right? So if mean temperature of heat addition has increased, automatically the Rankine cycle efficiency increases. So before going on to this, we will see the TS diagram and let me explain the TS diagram. So on TS diagram, original cycle will be 1, 2, 3, 4 to 1. Now, what we are going to study? Effect of superheating steam to high temperature. So at same pressure, we are just increasing the temperature to 1 dash. So what is the new cycle now? TS on TS diagram, it will be 1 dash, 2 dash, 3, 4 to 1 dash. This is the second cycle. So the you can see over here, it is visible. So if the process is heat addition process is from 4 to 1 in original cycle, and when we are superheating it to higher temperature, so you can see heat addition process from 4 to 1 dash. Mean temperature of heat addition will increase. So average temperature at which heat is transferred to the steam can be increased without increasing the boiler pressure by superheating the steam to higher temperature. So because of this, what will happen? There will be increase in heat input. There will be increase in work output. You can see this height is also increased. But what is the overall effect? Again, here this heat addition effect will be less as compared to work output. So overall effect will be what? Increase in efficiency of Rankine cycle. Why? Because mean temperature of heat addition we are increasing. So if you see now, compare this original cycle 1 to 2. Original cycle 1 to 2. Notice the dryness fraction. For point number 2, see the dryness fraction curve. It will be like this. So quality is low. But when we are superheating the steam, in that case you can see 0.2 dash, that is after expansion, the quality has increased. Now this superheating temperature, it depends on what? Metallurgical considerations. We can go only up to certain limits which is defined by metallurgical considerations. Now next method is increasing the boiler pressure. So original cycle you can see. Now for comparison purpose, we are maintaining on TS diagram same Tmax. Here you can see same Tmax is there. And original cycle is 1, 2, 3 to 4 to 1. Now since we are increasing the boiler pressure, to maintain constant temperature, 0.1 dash has shifted towards left. So this is the new cycle, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 and 4 dash, or 3 dash, 3 dash and 3 overlap. So here you can see now, again mean temperature of heat addition has increased if you increase the boiler pressure. And when you see, if you compare these two diagrams, for fixed inlet temperature of the turbine, if you increase the boiler pressure, cycle shift towards left hand side. Okay, you can see this green color cycle, it has shifted towards left. Now what happens because of this is efficiency of the cycle will increase. Why? Because we are increasing mean temperature of heat addition. So efficiency of cycle is increasing because of increasing boiler pressure. But you can see point number 1 to 2, originally this was point number 2, and 2 dash point, it has shifted towards left. So quality has decreased and moisture content has increased. So this moisture, it will impinge on the blades of the turbine and there will be erosion of the turbine blades. So this will be undesirable. So in order to overcome this disadvantage of increasing boiler pressure, because of the increase in boiler pressure, quality of the steam decreases. Quality decreases means what? Dryness fraction reduces. Dryness fraction reduces means moisture content increases. So this moisture will impinge on the turbine blades and it will cause erosion. So in order to avoid this, there are two solutions with us, if you think. What is the first solution? First solution is superheat steam to a very high temperature. So what I can do? Observe this. Point number one dash, what I will do is I will superheat this to a high temperature and then expand. So what will happen? Let me show you. If I am superheating over here and then I am expanding here, you can see point number two quality has increased. Okay, this is one solution, but this is limited by metallurgical consideration. We have to say check the safety also in that case. What is the second solution now? What is the second solution? So second solution is what? We can go for Rankine cycle with reheat. That is known as reheat cycle. So next cycle, next slide, we will see what do you mean by reheat. So what do you mean by reheat? We have two turbines in this case. So understand this diagram first, then we will see TH diagram and HH diagram. You have numericals also on this one. Okay, so understand this properly. So first turbine is known as high pressure turbine. Okay, first understand the parts. So from boiler, we will have steam at high pressure. So that is why first turbine is which turbine? High pressure turbine. Then this high pressure turbine, at the exit you can see the steam enters the boiler where it is reheated. That is why this is known as reheat Rankine cycle. So this is reheated, and then this steam moves back to the next turbine. So now the second turbine will be which type of turbine? Low pressure turbine, because at point number one we have high pressure steam. Now the pressure has reduced, so this is low pressure turbine. So from both turbine, high pressure turbine and low pressure turbine, they are coupled to a central shaft, and that shaft will rotate and you will get power. Now the exit, point number four, exit from the low pressure turbine, it goes to the condenser where steam gets condensed to the saturated liquid at point number 5, and 5 to 6 will be pumping action, isentropic pumping, and from 6 to 1 it will be constant pressure heat addition in boiler. Now what happens because of this? Let me explain you the important concept. Okay, so usually what happens, if you see this cycle, forget about this part, reheat part. Usually what will happen when you draw a normal Rankine cycle, this will be like this. 1 to 2 will be like this. So here you can see the quality is less if you increase this superheat value. Now what I can do is I can move, I will have expansion in turbine 1, high pressure turbine. So 1 to 2 expansion I will have. Then I will reheat the steam from 2 to 3, and then again I will expand the steam in second turbine from 3 to 4. So now you can compare this outlet of the steam and this one. Quality has increased. So this is the advantage of reheat Rankine cycle. So quality of the steam at the exit of the turbine, it increases, means dryness fraction value, it increases, it becomes closer to 1. So because of that, moisture content reduces and life of the turbine increases. Now we will see the TH diagram and HH diagram. So HH diagram will be more important to us when we solve numericals. So now what is process 1 to 2? It will be isentropic expansion in high pressure turbine. So here 1 to 2, you can see this is point number 1 and this is point number 2. So this will be in which region? This is in superheated region. Okay, so 1 to 2, point number 2, you can see over here, we are assuming that point number 2 is saturated vapor. So point number 1, we are assuming it has to be superheated vapor, and after the expansion in turbine, isentropic expansion, point number 2, we are considering as saturated vapor. Okay, if data is not given, we can assume this. Now, again, you can see from point number 2, the steam enters the boiler for reheating purpose. So in boiler, again at constant pressure, this is constant pressure curve. So from 2 to 3, let me show over here, this is pressure equal to constant. This 2 to 3, from this point to this point, this will be pressure equal to constant. Now this curve, if you see Mollier diagram, we have already discussed Mollier diagram. On Mollier diagram, this is the nature of constant temperature line in superheated region. So this temperature T1 will be equal to T3. So after reheating, here also one assumption we are making, that this T3 temperature after reheating, it is equal to the initial temperature T1. This is also assumption. So the first assumption is, after the expansion we have saturated vapor. This is first assumption. Now constant pressure reheating is done in the boiler again, and T3 is equal to T1. This is also assumption. Now this point number 3, steam enters the low pressure turbine and it will expand. Steam will expand in the turbine. So here you can see from 3 to 4 steam is expanding in the turbine, and both the turbine has same shaft and it is generating power. From 0.4 to 0.5 we have constant pressure heat rejection, and at point number 5 again you can see one assumption we are making, that steam has condensed to saturated liquid. This assumption we are making. If it is given in the question, in the numerical it is subcooled, you can take subcooled. If data is not given, then you have to assume that it is saturated liquid. Now from 0.5 to 0.6, here you can see it is isentropic compression, pumping action. So 5 to 6 it will be isentropic compression, and 6 to 1 it is constant pressure heat addition. So again 6 to 1 this will be constant pressure. So let me write it down. So this is also pressure equal to constant. So P6 will be equal to P1. Note this, P6 pressure will be equal to P1 pressure. Now there is isentropic expansion in turbine number 1 and pressure drops. And now pressure P2 will be equal to pressure P3. Why? Because again this is constant pressure heat addition in this one. So this red color part, reheating part, is over here. And original boiler part, 6 to 1 will be over here. These two are heat addition processes. And if you consider turbine number 1, for turbine number 1, 1 to 2, this will be expansion from where you are getting power. So this is first expansion in turbine number, high pressure turbine. And if you consider low pressure turbine, this will be the expansion in low pressure turbine. So from here also you are getting work from the turbine. This is work from LP turbine 3 to 4. And this part 1 to 2 will be work from HP turbine. Work you will get over here. And if you consider process 6 to 1, this will be heat addition. So this is heat addition. Suppose this is QS1, heat addition 1, and 2 to 3 also you have heat addition. So this one will be heat addition 2. On similar basis, I have shown over here TH diagram. So on TH diagram, obviously, again we will see some assumptions. Point number 5 we are assuming as saturated liquid, and point number 1 we have considered superheated steam, and after the expansion in the steam, isentropic expansion, point number 2 we are assuming it as saturated vapor. Then there is constant pressure heat addition in reheater. This is known as reheater. So two to three process is reheating process at constant pressure. Then we have 3 to 4 isentropic expansion, and then 4 to 5 will be constant pressure heat rejection in condenser. 5 to 6 will be again isentropic pumping or compression, and 6 to 1 will be heat addition in boiler. So again, to compare these two diagrams, from 6 to 1, this will be boiler process, heat addition in boiler, 6 to 1, QS1. So it will be QS1. And if you consider this one, reheating, it will be from 2 to 3. So again, this is at constant pressure, this will also be at constant pressure. So this one will be QS1. And here also you will have heat addition, which is QS2. QS2. Again, expansion is in HP turbine from 1 to 2. So here you will have expansion, and from here you are getting WHP. And when you consider LP turbine, it will be from 3 to 4. And from here you will get WLP. So I hope this reason is now understood. So what we do is, from point 1, if we directly go to 2 dash, dryness fraction has reduced. Okay, quality of the steam has reduced. There is more moisture content. So what we do? From this point, we go to constant pressure and we reheat this. So this will be constant pressure reheating, and then we expand. So that our exit point of the turbine quality increases. So again, if you see here, in this case, mean temperature of heat addition increase. Why? Because we are adding heat over here and here also. So mean temperature of heat addition increases. So efficiency of reheat Rankine cycle will be more as compared to Rankine cycle. Okay. Now we will see the analysis part. See the equations. Now heat is added where? Heat is added. See the HS diagram for formulas. How to remember the formula? Heat is added during process 6 to 1 in main boiler, and during reheating process. So this is process. This is process 6 to 1 in boiler. Okay, this process. So heat is added over here. And the second process where heat is added, it is from 2 to 3. What is this 2 to 3? It is this reheater part. So this is 2 and this one is 3. So in case of reheating also, heat is added. So what will be the total heat addition process? It will be H1, okay, higher enthalpy H1 minus H6 plus. It will be H3 minus H2. Okay, it will be QS1 plus QS2. Similarly, if you consider heat rejection, where is heat rejected? Heat rejection happens only once. Okay, it is there in, where it is? In condenser. Heat is rejected in condenser during process 4 to 5. So during process 4 to 5, what is the higher enthalpy minus lower enthalpy? It will be H4 minus H5. So you can see heat rejection formula, it is H4 minus H5. Now turbine work. Turbine work, work is generated in two turbines, HP turbine, during process 1 to 2. So during process 1 to 2, this one will be HP turbine. And during process 3 to 4, this will be work obtained in LP turbine. Now what is this enthalpy difference? It will be H1 minus H2. So H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4 plus H3 minus H1. So this will give total work, turbine work. So this will be WT, turbine work. Now what is the pumping work? Pumping is done in which case? Here you can see pumping action. It is from 5 to 6. What is the higher enthalpy? H6. So H6 minus H5. So this will be H6 minus H5. So what is now W net? W net, we have already discussed this. W net will be WT minus WP. So this formula remains same. Okay, but substitution of WT will be different. Usually it was only the H1 minus H2. Now in this case, we have H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4. Similarly, in case of pump, we have H6 minus H5. Usually we had 3 to 4. So H4 minus H3 we had in previous case. Okay, in normal Rankine cycle. Now what will be the efficiency of this Rankine cycle? Efficiency will be W net upon QS. So W net will be calculated using this equation, and QS will be calculated using this equation. You should note that heat is added two times. It will be QS1 in boiler during process 6 to 1, and then in reheater from process 2 to 3. Okay, you should remember this. And the specific steam rate, steam consumption or steam rate formula, then work ratio, and heat rate, these formulas will remain as it is. Now, what are the advantages of this reheat cycle? So by having this reheat arrangement, we can employ higher boiler pressure, and because of that we can have higher thermal efficiency without worrying about the erosion of the blade. So here we had discussed, if we increase the boiler pressure, quality reduces. But what we will do is, if we increase the boiler pressure from here, we can reheat and then again expand. So the quality increases. So we don't have to worry about the quality when we go for reheat. So erosion of the blade reduces, and because of that turbine life increases. Now, what is the steam rate formula? 3600 upon W net. As W net is increasing because of reheat, W net increases. So as W net increases, steam rate decreases. And as steam rate decreases, we had already defined the steam rate and we had seen importance of steam rate. If steam rate decreases, what do you mean by that? There is reduction in the size and costing of boiler, piping and turbine. So overall initial cost of boiler, piping and turbine, that will significantly reduce. Okay, so because of reheat, W net increases, and since W net is increasing, steam rate decreases. When you increase the W net value in denominator, what will happen to steam rate? It decreases. And steam rate decreases means what? Size and cost of the boiler, piping and other equipment, it will also reduce. Now, what are the disadvantages of this reheat cycle? So because of this reheating, you can see some additional components are added, right? What are the additional components? Extra piping is there, reheater is there. Okay, extra turbine is there. So because of that, what will happen? Initial cost is more because of reheated tubes and extra piping. Reheating will require more maintenance. Okay, because see, there will be two turbines. There will be two different turbines. So you need to open both the turbines and you have to do, there will be more maintenance required in that case. Now, since heat rejected in condenser is more as compared to Rankine cycle for the same size, cost of the condenser will be more. Okay, so since the condenser in case of reheat cycle, it will be of bigger size, so cost will be more, because in this case, since we are supplying more heat, heat rejection will also be more.